Maiden City Motor Club, as part of their contribution to their City of Culture Year, are bringing the rural sport of rallying right into town.
Lark in the Park joins an impressive list of events celebrating Derry Londonderry's selection as the UK City of Culture in 2013.
Yes, we've been having quite a party up here in the northwest, and it's only just starting. So let's see who's going to be having fun on the John Mulholland Motors Lark in the Park, right here in the Maiden City.
The headquarters and service park is in Ebreton Barracks, and the sponsor's support has made the revival of this event possible.
We felt it important to try and bring something back and give something back to the city. I've been involved in motorsport for 30 years now myself, and particularly involved in rallying, which is very close to my heart, and trying to couple that with our own business, we thought it a great opportunity to sponsor this event and to be the headline sponsor.
The number one seed is the new generation WRC Mini of Draperstown's Derek McGeehan.
It is good that the club has got it back. It's good for the area. I've done it once before, and it's back 13, 15 years ago maybe, the first time it ran, so it's been a while for I've been here.
At number two, it's Kieron Graffin in the Hyundai WRC.
Genuine X-Works car, that's one of the last 3.5s ever built by Hyundai. So it's good wee cars, proper X-Works car, so it is.
Sean Cassidy has his four-wheel drive Fiesta at number three.
It's bringing rallying to the people in the middle of the city, and that's what it's all about. It's a good PR exercise for the club, for motorsport, and for the companies that sponsor the rally and everything else.
Richard Hogg has run many Maiden City events.
That's one thing I'll say about the motorsport is, as a city of culture, motorsport's a very apolitical sport, so it's fantastic. It matches itself very well for what everybody's trying to do in the city here.
St. Columb's Park is a short stroll across the Peace Bridge, and 40 rally cars are in flight.
They won't have time to blink, as there are just 5 stages and all are only a mile in length. So no mistakes, guys. Behave yourselves.
They do have to behave, as the punishment on this tight course can be more severe than the crime. The slightest mistake and the rally is gone. Stage 1, and we take a ride with Richard Hogg and Mark Hanna in their Group A Evo 6. The opening stage, a clockwise loop, is the shortest of the day at 0.7 of a mile. Richard tweaks the handbrake, or the wand as they call it in these parts, to negotiate that first hairpin. Fast bit here before this tight downhill section where the roots of the trees stick out to catch you. Now for the right. Too fast here and you could be in the river on your left. Then a flat out blast up the narrow track with a dangerous drop off on the left. Heavy braking into an uphill 90 degree right and another pull on the wand. Then it's another hairpin left around the hill where St. Columb's statue stands, over a sleeping policeman and a square left to finish. And that's stage 1, 58 seconds of concentration. As we see from the bumper of Kieron Graffin's Hyundai, on stages 2 and 3, you turn right before the final hairpin and rejoin at the first hairpin to take in an extra lap, bringing the distance up to a mile. Derek McGeehan is first to tackle stage 1, and he's a little confused as he believes that this one is purely a sighting one. He doesn't drive at 10 tenths. He's joint third fastest, a full 3 seconds off the fastest time, and that could cost him the rally. On stage two, he's up to pace in the 1600cc WRC Mini, and second fastest, just a second off the fastest time. This moves Derek and Laurie Smith into second place in this latest spec Pro Drive Mini.
3, 2, 1.
Kieron Graffin, the first stage is a disaster. He stalled the Mulholland Hyundai on the start line and dropped 7 seconds to the leader, right down the placings to 17th. The Tombridge Rally car trader is a little unfamiliar with the ex-Freddie Loic's car, and with this stall has gone any hope of a win today. As Kieron shows, those metal hoops on the outside of some of the bends leave no room for error. Now he must try and keep his cool and try to climb back through the field, but there just isn't the mileage on this event to make up the deficit. On stage two, however, he's joint second fastest with McGeehan, and that's enough to improve his situation by 13 places and to move him into an amazing fourth position overall. Maybe all is not lost, as others can make mistakes too.
Long four right tightens, don't punt.
Sean Cassidy's pretty Fiesta has Escort WRC running gear underneath its skin, but the Macrofelt driver is also in trouble on the first stage, and that overshoot drops him to 27th. However, a fourth fastest time on stage two brings him up to 14th as wife Martina calls the pace notes.
They're
hanging onto Richard Hogg and Mark Hanna's Mitsubishi on stage one as we skim past the scenery on our way to a fastest time. This is the way to do it. Controlled aggression. We haven't seen much of the Limavady driver in the past few seasons. His Evo 6, which is a stretched Group N car, is the former property of the legendary Micey Manning from Barbados. We would be proud of our Richard right now, as he's 4 seconds faster than the rest after just 1.7 miles.
Square left.
Adrian Hetherington, on his first visit to the park, is learning the ropes in 11th place. Alan Atchison, another park novice, is doing the same in 16th. This is the time and place to entertain, and Donegal's Geoffrey Dolan is doing just that in his sunbeam. He's certainly having a lark as he broadsides past the mark.
But local driver Derek Gurney and co-driver Keith McAvoy are playing with the big boys today in their home-built, low-budget 2-litre Sierra. They are joint fifth overall in an epic three-way tie for the two-wheel drive lead after two stages. Joe McGonigal from just across the Donegal border in Muff pops his R3 Clio into 18th after two tests. Joe, conscious of his forthcoming British Championship event, doesn't want to do any damage here. Strabane's Stanley Ballantyne in his Evo 9 is settling in after a big crash last year. And Andrew Bustard is joint 11th and right in the thick of the Mark II Escort mayhem. Ian Miller is debuting his brand new historic BDA Escort today. He's leading the class and is 8th overall after being joint fastest 2-wheel drive on stage 1. William McFadden is joint 11th and on the climb as he drifts his G3 Escort beautifully round the final hairpin. Keith Cheshire is joint 8th after two stages, and he is another to get that hairpin just right. Johnny Morrow raises the dust in his Toyota Corolla in 14th place. Brendan O'Hagan is just 1 second behind him in his Evo 6, but not dropping any time in the similar Group N Evo 6 is number 17 seed Darren McKelvey. The Castledown driver is really motoring in a fabulous third place overall, just 6 seconds behind the rally leader. Erwin Craig in his 2-litre Escort is 10th overall, but Kevin Bradley in his smaller capacity 1600 example is tying for the 2-wheel drive lead. Indeed, after stage one, Kevin was joint third fastest, and he is now joint fifth. Just where are we all going? It seems that Jared Mullen is pointing his 106 in the right direction anyway. We climb on board with PJ Bonner and Vicky Kane in the 2.4-litre Mark II Escort. as PJ struggles to keep his wild charge pointing in the right direction. Let it all hang out, PJ. It's quite a job controlling the powerful NPL Utilities Mark II in the tight confines of the park. The Mark IIs are still the people's favourites, and this is why. It's not the quickest way, but who cares? It's fun. And PJ has drifted into 23rd place. But who is at the top of the two-wheel drive leaderboard? Joint top in their front-wheel drive C2R2 after two stages are Alan Smith and Peter Thompson. But Derek Jobs' similar machine is heading for the trees. After two stages, it looks like a walk in the park for Richard Hogg. But we're only halfway there and mistakes are oh so easy to make. The sun may be out, but the temperature is cool as the free entertainment for all the family hots up at the halfway mark of the revived John Mulholland Motors Lark in the Park.
Plum has bumped into an old friend, a man with a remarkable rallying pedigree.
For 52 years, Mervyn Johnson has been rallying minis, and at the age of 73, he hasn't hung up his helmet yet.
It's an amazing career. When did it all start?
My first rally was at OMA in 1961.
And in a mini, of course.
In a mini. The only time I ever drove anything else was on the Isle of Man. I drove a Mazda XR2 belonging to Ronnie McCartney. Around the early 70s, we had a good run. We finished fourth overall on the circuit and then the Welsh and the Isle of Man. Well, I think the most disappointing one was the first International Galway. We were leading it on the second last stage. We took a wrong turn coming out from the previous stage and thought I had lost the rally, so when we were leading it and was a wee bit just a bit apprehensive about finishing, and we went over a yoke too hard and somersaulted and lost the rally.
You've won hosts of championships, how many?
I think we've won four Irish historic championships.
And the Tullyhaman Flyer, as Mervyn has always been known, clocks up another class win today.
But now, for the more modern machinery. And on to stage three, where rally leaders Richard Hogg and Mark Hanna are about to clock up another fastest time.
100, don't cut square right!
That opens up a 5-second advantage.
Yeah, no, it's going very well. Plenty of grip, and we're just really, really enjoying ourselves. We're getting quicker as we go along. I really thought the other guys would have been coming at us, but we've managed to fend them off. It's quite a fast car. I mean, it does go very, very well. That's the next Barbados car, actually. That's nice old car, so it's a very, very good car. It goes well, plenty of speed in it, and we just seem to be getting into flow. It's a funny place here. You get into flow or you don't get into flow. If you get into flow in here, you go very well, and if you don't, it's a very, very difficult place.
Derek McGeehan just can't match the Mitsubishi in his modern Mini. The Draperstown engineer is just 1 second slower than Richard again here. He has a 5-second breathing space to third.
On the first stage this morning, I slept in. When I heard it was familiarisation, I just went out and played around. Next thing, the times were live and Richard got a jump on us. But he's beaten me by a second in each stage there over two stages. So I'm enjoying it, but keep myself mannerly. I don't want to be clouting her anywhere.
Kieron Graffin and Aidan Friel's remarkable recovery in so few miles will move them into joint third position after this stage. But it's unlikely they'll climb any higher, as delays have meant the organisers have to shorten the event. One more stage will decide the results.
First stage we stalled, I lost 5 or 7 seconds when we started. You know yourself, you get a bit flustered after that. So I think we matched Derek and won, and we were second off and we won the other. So the times is there. It's seat time again. It's just getting into it. Northern car, you know.
Darren McKelvey is joint third with Kieron and leads Group N. And Kevin Bradley in that 1600 Mark II jointly leads the two-wheel drive race as he flirts with disaster on stage three. Was a little too close for comfort. Derek Gurney's smoothly driven Sierra is dead level on time, with just one stage now to decide the overall honours.
So it's too slidey for any messing, and as soon as you go sideways, you're lost in time straight away, so just try and keep her smooth, just, and that's it.
On the same overall time now is Sean Cassidy, who's joint third fastest on this test. Willie McFadden is 2 seconds further back in eighth, and he's just 1 second in front of Ian Miller, who's enjoying his new mount.
It's good, hey. It's good. The sun's out and we're enjoying ourselves and good out run now. It's the first time out in this car here, so just getting used to this gearbox and bits and pieces.
On equal time with Ian is Erwin Craig, with Adrian Hetherington just 1 second behind. Close times and entertaining motoring. That's what the public enjoy at this motorsport festival. Until it dreams so hard to beat. Every time she walks down the street, another girl in the neighborhood. When she was mad, she looks so good. I wanna hold her, wanna hold her tight. Get teenage kicks right through.
Now, with just one stage to go in the Lark in the Park and a lot of drivers tied in the same time, there's a lot to be decided in the final mile. PJ Bonner will tie for 19th place as he shows us the anti-clockwise format of stage 4, so it's right at the first hairpin. Then through the new chicane and the uphill left-hander, through that very narrow gap in the trees. You could do damage there. Another girl in the neighborhood. Now we tread the escort uphill towards another gravelly square left. Then it's around the long sweeping right-hander and a long left in front of the large crowd as we head for lap 2. It's important to remember to keep left for another lap as PJ pulls the handbrake on for the final time today. Also finishing in joint 19th position are Andrew Bustard and David Young.
Kevin and Peter Ward finish 18th, 3 seconds in front of PJ.
Tying for 16th are the two Evos of Keith Cheshire and Brendan O'Hagan.
Just 2 seconds in front is the ever-cheerful Stanley Ballantyne in his newer Evolution 9 version.
Johnny Morrow will claim 14th overall and second in Class 5 with his Toyota twin cam.
Alan Acheson and Joe Harper are just 1 second in front of them in 13th.
Joe McGonigal gets his Clio home safely in 12th before being transported to the opening British Rally Championship round.
Whilst Ian Miller wins the historic class and finishes joint 10th in his new machine.
He shares that position with Adrian Hetherington, who is 1 second faster on this final blast, and late in the day, he gets into the groove on his park debut.
Erwin Craig and David Hamilton take a fine 9th, just 1 second behind Willie McFadden and Francis Devine in 8th position.
Kevin Bradley wins Class 5, second two-wheel drive, and 7th overall, whilst Kieron Graffin, who started this stage in 3rd, is also set to drop a few places. It all starts well for the Toon driver, and on lap 1, there are no mistakes.
100. Tight 4 right opens and tightens. Carry, keep on the power.
But coming onto lap 2, they need to keep left. But he points the Hyundai towards the stage finish.
Opens. No.
It requires a time-consuming lock through the park trees and costs him 3 places, dropping to 6.
Climbing into 5th, it's Derek Gurney who takes the two-wheel drive honours. It's a fine achievement for the Maiden City Club member and his co-driver Keith McAvoy in their self-prepared, naturally aspirated Cosworth engine Ford Sierra. The only problem Derek has today is a broken champagne cork.
He just says we keep it, you know, tidy and try and keep her straight and keep her going forward, like, so I seem to have paid off for us, you know, I sort of.
Sean and Martina Cassidy are second fastest on the final test to climb back from their stage 1 overshoot to finish 4th. Their little four-wheel drive Fiesta has run faultlessly.
After a faultless drive, Darren McKelvey and Denver Rafferty are third and first in Group N.
On it from the word go, and just kept it neat and tidy and paid off. But still, very, although it was very tight, it's very, very fast. So, yeah, very, very happy.
Equally happy with their second place are Derek McGeehan and Larry Smith. It's another good result for the WRC Mini in Ireland. Without that first stage misunderstanding and a couple of moments on the grass, things could have been very different.
It takes very little in summers with height. There's very little miles to try and pull anything back there. It's just point and squirt. But a couple of mistakes myself, just been on the grass, lost a bit of time. But a good day's fun, that was the main thing. Take it home in one piece.
Richard Hogg shaves off the Mitsubishi's mirror on that bale. That's cutting it fine. But apart from that, and a worrying vibration from the left rear wheel, he continues to dominate. He's fastest once again, and now heads towards an 8-second victory after four stages. It's an old Mitsubishi, and it's being guided by his old mate, Mark Hanna. But Richard seems to excel where accuracy counts. The whole event has taken him just 5 minutes 48 seconds. But perhaps that's plenty for a middle-aged man. The Maiden City Motor Club have brought their sport right into the heart of their city and into the hearts of its citizens.
It's a fantastic event. I think it's great to bring this into the city. I think it's great for the city of culture. And as I say, you know, it's great to let people see what we do, you know, throughout the rest of the year when we're out on the open stages in the backcountry somewhere.
Again, the Limavani driver takes home the trophy, and Richard and Mark receive the Cyril Doherty Memorial Trophy from Clock of the Course, Ian Connolly.
So, Richard Hogg has had the last laugh at the John Mulholland Motors Lark in the Park.